Now children, the fourth sum in the exercise we shall discuss now. So what it says, you see here, prove that the tangents are drawn at the ends of a diameter of a circle or parallel. So here, according to the statement, I have drawn a circle here and the diameter of the circle AB. At the ends of the diameter, that is at A and B, have drawn the two tangents, that is RS and PQ. So if that is the case, what we have to show? We have to show that PQ is parallel to RS. Okay, you see children here, according to the statement, let AB be the diameter of the circle with the center O, with its center O. Two tangents, that is PQ and RS, are drawn at the ends of the diameter AB. PQ and RS are drawn at the end points of the diameter AB. Okay, what we have to show that? We have to show that, that is PQ parallel to E. RS. Okay, here you see children, here in theorem 4.1 you have studied, whenever the radius and the tangent, they meet each other, they form 90 degree at the point of contact, isn't it? So similarly here you see the diameter is twice the radius, isn't it? That is, here you see children, this diameter, the one of the end point is A, that is RS is drawn. So therefore, here it is the radius and the tangent at the point of contact is 90 degree. Therefore, angle O, that is OA perpendicular to RS. Similarly, OB perpendicular to PQ, according to theorem 4.1. Clear children? Here you see children, here since they are perpendicular to each other, children, you see angle RAB is equal to angle SAB, they form 90 degree because the radius and the tangent at the point of contact. Okay, similarly on the other side, that is angle PBA is equal to angle QBA is equal to 90 degree. The reason is same, that is radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. Clear children? So here you see, I am taking these two angles, that is, so here PQ and RS are the two lines. Here AB acts as a transversal. AB acts as a transversal. You know that children. So on either side of this line segment, the angle form is 90 degree each, isn't it? So I am considering here angle RAB and angle QBA. They form alternate angles, and also they are equal in measurement. So since the alternate angles are equal, then what we can say, that if a transversal cuts the two lines, if the alternate angles are equal, then those two lines are parallel to each other. You have studied in the 8th as well as in the 9th standard. Here also, the alternate angles, that is angle RAB is equal to angle QBA, they form equal angle, that is 90 degree. Since alternate angles are equal children, that is the lines, that is PQ is parallel to RS. Clear children? Okay, you take down children. Now children, we shall take the next sum, that is the fifth sum in the exercise number 4.2, the circles. See what it says here. Prove that the perpendicular at the point of contact to the tangent to a circle passes through the center. Okay, so here we have drawn the figure here, that is a circle with the center O and the tangent AB, and the tangent AB is touching the circle at P. Okay, yes, so we have to show that the perpendicular drawn from the point of contact to the center of a circle is always perpendicular. Okay, this we have to prove by contradictory method, saying that it is not passing through the center. Then afterwards we have to show that, so whenever whenever the perpendicular drawn from the center is always passes through the center, we have to show. So this method of proving, we call it as contradictory method. First we say that it is not passing, then we say that it is passing. So it is a perpendicular. Clear, children? So here let AB be the tangent drawn at the point P on the circle with the center O. Join OP. Okay. Now let us assume that Q is another point. So let us assume that that is PQ is perpendicular to AB, that is tangent, which is not passing through the center. Q is another point, it is other than O, that is center of the circle. So that is PQ is perpendicular. Let us assume that the PQ is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. Let us assume that. Okay, so this PQ is not passing through the center of the circle O. Okay, you see, children, as assumed that PQ is parallel to AB, PQ is perpendicular to AB, PQ is perpendicular to AB, then what is the angle QPB equals? Since we have assumed that it is perpendicular, therefore that is angle QPB is equal to 90 degree. This is what we have constructed here to prove that. Okay, so let it be equation 1. Now you know that OP, we have joined OP. OP is the radius to the tangent AB at P. OP is the radius to the tangent AB at the point of contact P. So what we have studied in the theorem 4.1, that is radius and the tangent are perpendicular to each other at the point of contact. That is what we have studied, isn't it, children, in theorem 4.1. So what it says, once again I am telling you, the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So therefore, according to theorem 4.1, that is angle OPB is equal to 90 degree. This is according to theorem 4.1. Therefore, here you see, let it be equation 2. Compare this equation 1 and 2. So equation 1, that is QPB is also equal to 90 degree, as well as OPB is also 90 degree. Is it possible to have 90 degree at the same point with the same line? So that is a contradiction. That is a contradiction. So PB is a line, isn't it? That is tangent. From Q also it forms 90 degree, From Q also it forms 90 degree, and from O also it forms 90 degree. It is contradiction, isn't it? So for the same line, for the same line segment, so is it possible to have two perpendicular lines at the same point? No, it is not possible, isn't it? So that is a contradiction. That means angle OPB is equal to angle QPB is equal to 90 degree. It is a contradiction, isn't it? So this is possible. If you know 90 degree aglik sadhya yavaga ante helidre, this is possible only when this Q merges with the point Q merges with O, or point Q coincides with O. ಅವೆರಡು ಲೈನ್ಗಳು ಒಂದೇ ಆದರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಓನ್ ವೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಕೋಯಿನ್ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಒ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಒ ಪಿ ಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 90. Angle OPB is equal to 90 degree. Hence, the perpendicular at the point of contact to the tangent to a circle passes always through the center of the circle. Did you understand, children? Okay, take down. See, children, here the sixth sum says the length of a tangent from a point at a distance of 5 cm from the center of the circle is 4 cm. Find the radius of the circle. That means the length of the tangent is 4 cm and the distance between the point A to the center of the circle is 5 cm. If that is the case, you have to find out the length of the radius. You see, children, here. So according to the statement, the figure is drawn. So by just seeing that figure, you can understand everything here. So here in the triangle, it forms a triangle here, radius, tangent, and the distance between the center to the point is 5 cm. So here in the triangle OPA, that is angle P is equal to 90 degree, that is according to theorem 4.1. Radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. So if that is the case, it forms a right angle triangle, isn't it? I can apply Pythagoras theorem. So if you apply Pythagoras theorem, square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides, that is AP square plus PO square or OP square by Pythagoras theorem. Substitute the values here, that is OA square is equal to 5 cm, that is 5 square. AP is equal to 4 cm, that is 4 square, plus OP is equal to question mark, that is the radius, that is OP square. So in place of OP, you can write R also, that is radius, okay? That is R square, that is radius square. Therefore, here you see, if you send this 16 to the left-hand side of equals, then it becomes 25 minus 16 is equal to R square, that is 25 minus 16, that is, if you take away 16 from 25, you are left with 9. So R square is equal to 9. R is equal to square root of 9, that is OP, that is nothing but the radius. Radius, that is nothing but OP, is equal to 4 cm. Therefore, the radius OP is equal to 3 cm. That is square root of 9 is 3 cm. Therefore, the radius, that is OP, is equal to 3 cm. Therefore, the radius of the circle is 3 cm. Clear, children? Okay, take down. Children, now we shall start the next question. So, seventh question, what it says, two concentric circles are of radius 5 cm and 3 cm. Find the length of the larger, find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. See, children, here have drawn the two circles, one is the smaller one, another one is a larger one. So both are having the same center, hence we call it as concentric circles. So there are two concentric circles, okay, so both are having the same center. The radius of the smaller circle is 3 cm and the radius of the larger circle is 5 cm. So here AB is drawn such that it is a chord of the larger circle and it is a tangent to the smaller circle. It is a tangent to the smaller circle at P. So what we have to find out here, we have to find out the length of the chord of the larger circle and at the same time it is a tangent to the circle with smaller radius. Clear, children? So now you see, children, here let the solution, you see, let O be the common center of the two concentric circles. Let A be a chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle at P. See, children, here, so with respect to the smaller circle, OP is the radius and AB is the tangent. They are having a common point contact, that is radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. You have studied in theorem 4.1. So therefore you see here I am joining OP and OA. If I join OA and OP, so angle OPB or angle OPA is equal to 90 degrees, because OP is perpendicular to AB. Clear, children? So according to 4.1 theorem, okay. So now you see, excuse me, in the triangle OPA, angle OPA is equal to 90 degrees, you know that. So therefore we can apply Pythagoras theorem for this triangle. So according to that, the hypotenuse, that is OA square, is equal to OP square plus AP square. You may know that the radius of this larger circle is 5 cm, that is OA square is equal to 5 square, and radius of the smaller circle is 3 cm, that is OP square is equal to 3 square. That we have to calculate the length of the AB, that is tangent to the smaller circle and chord of the larger circle, that is AP square. So 5 square is 25 is equal to 3 square is 9 is equal to AP square. Then if you bring this 9 to the left hand side of equals, it becomes minus 9. 25 minus 9 is equal to 16 is equal to AP square. Then if you take the square root of AP, that is 16, that is equal to 4 centimeter. That is AP is equal to 4 centimeter. So already I have taught you, that is whenever we are teaching about the chord and the radius in the properties of circles, the perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord bisects the chord. It divides the chord into two equal parts. Here you see OP is a perpendicular, AB is a chord. So then that OP divides the chord into two equal halves. That is, suppose you consider, that is AP is equal to L unit, then PB is also L unit, then the length of AB is equal to 2L. We can say 2L length. Clear, children? That means the AP length is half of AB. AP length is half of AB. At the same time, PB length is also half of AB. That is, AP is equal to half of AB, that is PB is also equal to half of AB. So I am applying that concept here. Then you see here the perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord bisects the chord. So that means, that implies that half of AB is equal to AP. If you send this two to the other side of equals, then it becomes AB is equal to twice the length of AP. Twice the length of AP. Then we know the length of AP. Substitute the value of AP in that. So then AB is equal to 2 into 4. Then the length of AB is equal to 8 centimeter. Therefore, chord AB is equal to 8 centimeter. Clear, children? This is how we can calculate. Understood? Right, take down, children. The next sum is 8th one. So what it says, you see here, a quadrilateral ABCD is drawn to circumscribe a circle. Prove that AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. Here you see, a quadrilateral ABCD is circumscribing a circle. That means, the circle is touching the sides of the quadrilateral, or sides of the quadrilateral are touching the circles at P, Q, R and S. As a result of this, the sides of the quadrilateral are nothing but the tangent to the circle. So now what we have to prove, that is AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. We have to show that. See, children, here. So according to the statement, the figure is drawn. So as in the figure, we have written here what are all the things. That is AB, BC and CD and DA are the sides of the quadrilateral ABCD. And also, that is AB, BC, CD and DA are the tangents to the circle with center O. Clear, children? So you know that the tangents from an external point are equal. You have learnt in the theorem 4.2. So we are using that concept here. You see? So here, A is an external point to the circle with the center O. There are two tangents, AP and AS. So these two, that is AP and AS, are equal because tangents from A. Clear, children? Similarly, here from point B, B is an external point. From the point B, there are two tangents are drawn, that is BP and BQ. So these two are the tangents from B, therefore these two are equal. Similarly, C is an external point to the circle. The two tangents, that is CR and CQ, are the tangents from an external point of the circle. So C, that is, therefore CR is equal to CQ. In the same manner, that is DS is equal to DR. Okay, so you see here, AP is equal to AS, tangent from A. Next, PB is equal to BQ, that is tangents from B are equal. Similarly, DR is equal to DS, that is tangents from D, and CR or RC. RC is equal to CQ, that is tangents from C are equal. That is according to 4.2, tangents from election point are equal. That is what the theorem 4.2 says. Okay. Now I'll take up the equation that is given in the question. The left hand side of equals. You see here, what is that left hand side of equation is AB plus CD I have taken here. So AB, the length of AB is nothing but AP plus PB, isn't it? So I have written, in place of AB, I split this AB into two parts, AP plus PB plus, and CD. So CD is nothing but the sum of the length, that is CR and DR. So RC plus DR, that is CD. Okay. So now you see what is AP is equal to. In place of AP, we can substitute AS. I have substituted here. In place of PB, we can substitute BQ because both are equal. Plus, in place of RC, we can substitute CQ. And in place of DR, we can substitute DS. After substituting these values here, I am rearranging the terms. You see, along with AS, I am writing DS. That is AS plus DS plus BQ plus CQ. Now look at this, children, here. Where is that AS and DS? AS and DS together makes the length of AD. So in place of AS plus DS, we can write AD and BQ plus CQ. So BQ plus CQ together, it makes the length of BC. That means in place of BQ plus CQ, we can write BC. So that is equal to RHS. From LHS, we got this RHS. This is to be proved. This has to prove. We have proved that. Okay. Understood, children? Okay. Take down, children. Okay. Children, now we shall take up the next sum, that is ninth sum in the exercise 4.2. You see what it says here. Here, the ninth sum. In figure, xy and x dash y dash, xy, x dash y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle with the center O. Okay, another tangent AB with point of contact C intersecting XY at A and X dash Y dash at B, prove that angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. That means angle AOB, this angle is equal to 90 degree. This we have to prove, children. You see, so according to the figure, the data has written here. In the figure, X dash and Y dash are parallel tangents. So X dash, XY and X dash, Y dash are the parallel tangents. Okay. Another tangent AB with C as a point of contact intersects XY at A and X dash Y dash at B. Okay. So what is to be proved? To prove that angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So as such, it is not possible to prove, children. For that, we are doing some construction here. What is that construction? What we did here? It is, we are joining OC. When we join OC, it has divided the triangle AOB into two triangles. Along with that, here you see, that is, it forms two triangles here, that is APO and ACO, and here also BCO and BQO. So like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 triangles are formed here. So 2 above the OC and 2 below the OC. Okay, children. Now, so I am going to consider these two triangles here. After joining OC, in the proof, I am considering the triangle OPA and OCA. I am considering these two triangles. Look here. So in these two triangles, is it possible to show these two triangles as congruent triangles? Look at this. So here, as you know that XY is a tangent, P is a point of contact. You know that angle APO is equal to 90 degree. Similarly, here you see OC is a radius and AB is a tangent, radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. So that means there are two triangles, both are right angle triangles. That is, one is APO, another one is ACO. So in these two triangles I am going to take to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Look at this here, children, here. In the triangle OPA and triangle OCA Look here, angle OPA is equal to angle OCA are equal to 90 degree. The reason is theorem 4.1. So what is that 4.1 theorem states? The radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. Clear, children? So therefore these two angles are equal to 90 degree. For both the triangles OPA and OCA, so there is a common side. That means for both the angles it is same. That is, OA is equal to OA, that is common side. And here you see AP is equal to AC. AP is equal to AC. How do you say that AP is equal to AC? That is, you see, A is an external point with respect to the circle with the center O. Two tangents, that is AP and AC, are drawn. So therefore, by theorem, what is the theorem? Theorem 4.2, what it says? Tangents from an external point are equal. Tangents from an external point are equal. Therefore, AP is equal to AC. AP is equal to AC. Okay. So here you see, it is a right angle. It is a, if this is the side, OA is the side opposite to right angle vertex, we call it as hypotenuse, that is H. And AP or AC are the two, are the sides of the right angle triangle, corresponding sides of the right angle triangle. So therefore, according to RHS postulate, right hypotenuse and a side postulate, triangle OPA, triangle OPA is congruent to triangle OCA. Clear, children? So these two triangles are congruent. Understood? Since these two triangles are congruent, children, look at this. What about these two angles? That is angle OAP and OAC. These two triangles are corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Hence, these two angles are equal. Angle OAP and angle OAC, these two triangles are equal. The reason is corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Clear, children? So we have proved these two angles are equal. That implies that here you see angle PAC, look here, the whole angle, that is angle PAC can be divided into two angles, which are those angle PAO atwa angle OAP and angle OAC. So both angles are equal. Therefore, what happens? Angle PAC is equal to twice the angle OAC. Twice the angle OAC. Angle PAC is equal to twice the angle OAC. Clear, children? Let it be equation 1. So this angle. Okay. Next. How we have proved in the above OC, in the same manner, so there are two triangles are below OC, that is angle QBO and CBO. These two triangles also we can show that these two triangles are congruent on the same RHS postulate. Clear, children? So you know that here also this form right angle. Radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. Radius and the tangent at the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. So on the base of the same concept, RHS postulate, we can show these two triangles are also congruent. Hence, angle QBO is equal to angle OBC. That is angle OBQ is equal to angle OBC. Okay, here these two angles are equal. Since these two angles are equal, one can be replaced by the other. So we can write it as angle QBC, the whole angle is equal to twice the angle OBC. Twice the angle OBC. Which one? Angle QBC is equal to twice the angle OBC. Let it be equation 2. Okay. But look at this, children, here. XY and X dash Y dash are parallel tangents. Here, AB acts as a transversal. You know that whenever a transversal intersects two parallel lines, the angles on the same side of a transversal, just you see, the angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. That means sum of these two angles is equal to 180 degree. Clear, children? That means angle PAB, or we can say that angle PAC plus angle QBC together, it makes 180 degree. Because these two are parallel lines and the XY axis is a transversal, and angle PAC and angle QBC are the interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Hence, the sum of these two is equal to 180 degree. This is what I have written here. Okay. Next. But PAC is equal to what? PAC is equal to twice the angle OCA. PAC is equal to twice the angle OAC plus angle QBC. QBC is equal to twice the angle OBC. Is equal to 180 degree. So in both the cases, we can find two common. So if I take two common outside, what remains in the bracket? Angle OAC plus angle OBC is equal to 180 degree. If I take away this two to the other side, then what it becomes? That is equal to 180 divided by 2 is equal to 90 degree. 180 divided by 2 is equal to 90 degree. So if I take away, I'll send this 2 to the other side. It will go to the denominator of 180. Then it becomes 90. That is, angle OAC plus angle OBC is equal to 90 degree. That means sum of these two angles is equal to 90 degree. Clear, children? Now, come to the next part of this. So, consider the triangle AOB. Consider the triangle AOB. Okay. In the triangle AOB, look here. Angle AOB plus angle OAC plus angle OBC. So sum of all the three angles of a triangle is equal to how much? 180 degree. You know that this property we have learnt, it has angle sum property of a triangle. According to angle sum property of a triangle, sum of all the three angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So which are all the three angles? So here you see angle AOB, first angle, angle OAC, that is second angle, OBC is the third. Sum of all the three is equal to 180 degree. Clear, children? So here we don't know the angle what AOB, keep it as such, angle AOB, but we know that what is the sum of these two. Sum of these two is equal to, we have proved here, that is angle OAC plus angle OBC is equal to 90 degree. In place of OAC plus OBC, you substitute 90 degree, children. Then in the next step, you see angle AOB is equal to, send this 90 to the other side of equals, where it goes, what it becomes, 180 plus 90 becomes minus 90. If you take away 90 degree out of 180 degree, what remains? That is, it remains 90 degree. What is that actually? The 90 degree is angle AOB. So angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. You see what is to be proved here? It is, we have to prove that angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. So we have proved here angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. Understood, children? Is it clear? Understood? Okay, take down.